Hello, kids. I'm back. Sorry to say, I am back. I'm trying to build up content for my channel so that I can get verified and lift this ridiculous viewer limit. So I'm going to get ready to do another live mix. I've got a live mix here ready to go in live, which I actually performed at the Northbridge Piazza on New Year's Eve last year to a good 1,000 people or something. It was really good fun. You're going to get to see how easy this is, which is maybe not a good thing. I don't know. Oh, is that what Pogo does? Shit, I could do that. What are people saying? Hi, Bye the Orion. Hi, Bunny. How you doing? It's actually evening time. I think it's good morning for you folks. Who has a nice voice? Sorry, maybe, anyway, nice voice you have. Ah, I think I know who he's talking about. She does, doesn't she? So anyway, yeah. Is it worth doing some Twitterage? I don't know. No one seems to really care that much. And anyway, it's got to be 8 in the morning over there. It's kind of crazy. Yes. But anyway, I've got all these controls ready to go. Let me double check that. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's ready. These are all my sound clips, which I'm going to use. And I'm even mixing in some lemon jelly and some Fatboy Slim, which I haven't really done before. So that's going to be fun. How do they say Fatboy Slim in Japan? What do you think? Fatu boy Sarimu or some shit. Ah, boy. The Wild Bunny. Yeah, she does. I'm going to get ready for work, but I'll be listening. Uh-oh. I think the set's going to be about an hour 45 by the looks of this thing. Yeah. I don't want to play tracks in their entirety. That's just boring. I'm going to be doing a lot of remixing here, which is the idea. Yeah, look, I'm just going to go with this. We've got 7 whole people, so... yeah. Fatuboyu Sarimu. Fatuboyu... I should ask Dusty about that. He'll know. Dusty speaks fluent Japanese. He'll be able to tell us how to say that in Japanese. Okay. Look, I am going to tweet this, but... really, I'm just doing this for something that people can watch later on Demandu. And I am sorry about the car adverts on the front, that really average-looking car that we're supposed to want to buy. I'm sorry about that. Let me twit it up. Tweet it up. Yeah, I just realized I do have my screen going out to live stream, so I need to be careful what I show and what I don't show. This is all good, though. Twitteru. Mixing live. Mixing live. No, I should just say mixing on live stream, which implies live anyway. Mixing live. Mixing on live stream soon. Come down if you're bored enough. There we go. Oh. Twitterage. Twitterage is always good. Okay. So, a little bit of technical insight. I do have some reverb, and I have some ping pong delay linked to some MIDI controllers here. And I also have a buffer shuffler, which is courtesy of the Max for MSP extension kit, which is what this big gizmo is down here. I've got that linked to controllers as well. And then, of course, I've got all my channels linked to faders, so I can trigger things. There's not really anything else I can do with this thing. That's more or less to my limit. It's freezing in here. Why isn't this heater working? I'm going to max that thing out. Maximum electricity. Yes, if you are bothered enough to join us, I'm going to be recording a quick live mix. Bunny asks, were you making an HDR photo with that car picture? Yeah, I kind of was. I don't know. I just thought I'd show people how I do it. Usually Enfuse GUI works, but in this case, it wasn't. It was doing a pretty shit job. It was looking worse than Photomatic's. Yeah, way early on the West Coast. Yeah, it probably is too early for everybody. But I am recording. Cool, I've always wanted to make some of those. Yeah, they're good fun. You should try, definitely download Enfuse GUI. It is very usable and it is free. It actually usually does a very good job. But you need to make sure your pictures are flat first. Lower that contrast, lower that brightness. And all shall be well. He says about shit that no one has any clue of what he's talking about. These are actually MIDI out clips, these yellow ones. These are for triggering video clips in Resolume, but because I haven't bothered to get all my video clips on this iMac, we won't be having any video. Ah, but it's nothing you haven't seen before. Just log on to YouTube. That sounds good. Thanks for that sound card. Lovely. Okay, well, I'll see how this view count goes. Again, I do apologize for the crappy car ads. I know that they're very boring-looking cars. I wouldn't mind so much if it was like a Lamborghini or something. That'd be nice. Come down and watch a pogo show and have a screening of a Lamborghini to start off with. That'd be great. But nope, it's a gray SUV, and apparently it's a new one. That's hard to believe. I do have tracks in their entirety because I didn't have... When I was preparing these sets, I didn't have the time... Oh, that's going to be annoying. Let me close that. Goodbye. I didn't have the time to splice these tracks into individual samples, which, believe me, is a very, very time-consuming process. It took me about a month to get all of this ready. And I do not look forward to doing it again, ever. MIDI clips, yeah. The way this works is you just have a MIDI note that goes out for each one of these clips, which is a ridiculously complicated system. I was thinking about using OSC, but I couldn't figure out how to do it, so I had to just use a MIDI note. Yeah. Anyway, if you're just joining us, I'm about to do some live mixing. This is a different set from the one I did last time. This is a whole bunch of... Well, differently mixed samples. I am going to be mixing in some Fat Boy. I'm going to be mixing in some Lemon Jelly, which went down very well on New Year's Eve when I played this. And yeah, look, you're probably looking at about an hour and 45. How are we looking here anyway? Where's my damn chat window? There it is. 23. Thanks for coming, folks. Up and at it already. That's right. Well, it's actually 8:17 p.m. here at the moment. I was using Lightroom and Photomatics. Yeah, Photomatics is pretty cool. And Lightroom. I haven't touched Lightroom before. I definitely needed girls near that car, although I don't think any girls would be one to be caught dead next to my car. What a piece of shit. A free masterclass. Yeah. A free noobular class. Get noobed by Pogo. Really. This is not nearly as complicated as it looks. I need a master control for this thing. Because I'm going to need to bring this music down when people ask me questions and shit. So... let me use this one. I'll map that. I'm actually using two different... Oh, no, I'm not. No, scrap that. Okay, cool. The great thing about live is you can set a maximum limit for your... where's it gone? There it is. I'm going to set that to -3 so that I don't over-amplify. There we go. Or even -5, I reckon. Yeah. -4. There we go. Well, This is going to be complicated, remembering all these faders. Welcome, Corey Evan. Thanks for coming. Slabbins says, I hate your accent. I hate it too, man. I should try using an American accent at some point. So basically, I've got my kick drums, my hats, my bass, my chords, my vocals, percussion. I've got two channels for tracks in their entirety. I've got a MIDI out that would export MIDI notes for all these video clips, but we're not doing that at this point because it's a hell of a setup and I can't be bothered. And then I've got a channel called Candy, which I really just use for crash cymbals and effects and all that silly hyping shit. It's like it's a hype man in a channel. It's pretty good. An MU holder, if you're wondering what that is a channel that usually has the output module that would output to my Jazz Mutant Lemur, which is a touchscreen that I used to use to control all of these clips. But instead, I'm going to be using my mouse, and I'm going to be using this MPD-26 to control the effects and the volume levels and what plays when and all of that bollocks. Okay, we got almost 30 people. I think when we hit 30, I'll just start. I'll get going. I'm an Aussie too, don't be ashamed. It's very hard for me not to be ashamed. This is a first for me with your live shiz. Yes, that's not the word I'd have chosen. I would have replaced the Z with a T. Can't wait. Cheers, he says. Thanks, buddy. Lachlan Hickey. That sounds like an Australian name indeed. What program are you using for this? This is Ableton Live. I was saying in an earlier stream, I really wish that Ableton Live had a dual monitor setup, because very often you need to be accessing your mixer here and accessing your sequencer here at the same time. You can only have one at a time, which is kind of annoying. I hope Ableton Live has a thing where you can have your mixer on a second display. That'd be very nice. But anyway, if you've just joined us, I've recently done a couple of streams of me going through Foley Moly and the Me Lurve Ooh tracks on SoundCloud. So you can check out how I've built those on Ableton Live, and hopefully it gives you an idea of how you can do this stuff yourself. Okay, I'm going to get going with this because I'm running out of things to open and close my mouth for. Let me just make sure all this is working. Yeah, okay. Enjoy.
You wrote an advert.
George, I think we should listen.
You said you wanted our help.
Go very well.
Never give and I'll never be this. Sing songs, us sing this. Never give.
Most interesting. I think we've had quite enough of this nonsense.
Oh, okay. That's what that knob does. These vocals need some more volume. Hang on a second. This is not working. Volume. How can I... I'll just chuck one of these on. That's a bit better. And moving on. Ooh, trippy. The fancy reverse button. Just joining us, folks. Thanks for coming down. I'm doing a live mix here for about an hour and 40 or an hour and a half. Hope you enjoy. I was kind of wanting that to echo a lot more than it did. Oh well. Randy.
Uncharted destruct space rain curb. Uncharted destruct
buzz to
light year
buzz
to
light
year
Space rain curb, uncharted destruct. Space rain curb, uncharted destruct.
Got one.
Two.
Planet Jerp.
Can you hear me? Got one.
Two.
Planet Jerp.
Can you hear me?
Drop my
take apart my.
On your
P.A. Pop.
Take apart my.
Buzz.
Two.
Light
here. Buzz.
Buzz.
Two.
Light here. Here.
Space rain curb, uncharted destruct. Space rain curb, uncharted destruct.
Buzz. Two.
Light here.
What happens if you reverse that? Yeah. Just sounds like a mess.
Is a kid who thinks you are the greatest, and it's not because you're a space ranger pal.
All right, everyone, this is a stick-up.
Can you help you what I when you're gonna come?
With style.
A track that I actually did as a commission, and at the time I released it, well, I didn't release it, I just used it in a set because I had nothing else to fill that time slot. Well, it's coming soon. Maggie from the Hook film. And this is the commission piece that I just chucked. Actually, I'm not playing this in its entirety, fair enough. Well, it's not worth it anyway. Good old Spielberg films. This movie was underrated. some Maggie. Give it some dance. The original. Which is less fun. Never actually listened to these kids on their own. Apparently there's swashbuckle percussion in there. Yeah. Swashubuckadoo. That's pretty cool. It's just weird. Bass doesn't work for me. Jeffrey Rush. This is Aztec gold. You don't know what this is, do you? Jeffrey Rush is an Australian, you know. No doubt I'm your father, right? Sarah Connor. Yeah. Casablanca meets Terminator. Vocals. I bet you the Wild Bunny could do a good impression of Alice. Just a hunch. That's what we need. These chords were something that I was making for a Portal 2 remix at the time, and these were, you know, drums and all that, and then I had this kind of bass going with it as well. So you had these, and then I was gonna try and get those chords in there, and I was gonna put in all the servos and all the machine noises. And then I was going to try and get, what's his voice? What's the Stephen Merchant guy? Weibo or something, the robot guy's voice. I was going to try and get him in there, which would have been cool. Like the Wizard of Oz track much anymore.
Six, oh, two.
Let's see what people are saying in the Baburi Gujatu. Yeah, I did take them from Bring Forth the Ring, that's right. Bring Forth the Ring was one of my first stupid Lord of the Rings things, but I made it with synths and it sounded ridiculous. Bass drum here is this bass drum is done in FL Studio. It's using FL Slayer, which is like an electric guitar sim, which is pretty good fun.
And
That's a little better.
Even rhymes.
Yeah, it does.
Bring it back on the mic.
Both out of those.
Everybody up. Go.
Would you sign off?
Turn my cup on the mic.
Both out of those.
Cut me in.
That's a rust. A weird. Bring it back on the mic.
Both out of those.
Everybody up. Go.
Would you sign off?
Turn my cup on the mic.
Both out of those.
Cut me in.
That's a rust. A weird. Bring it back on the mic.
Both out of those.
Everybody up. Go.
Would you sign off?
Turn my cup on the mic.
Both out of those.
Cut me in.
That's a rust. A weird. Bring it back on the mic.
Both out of those.
Everybody up. Go.
Would you sign off?
Turn my cup.
Alrighty, I wonder what track that could be. Thanks for coming down, folks. I'm doing some live mixing here. Let's see. Let's start off with this next one. This is a choir out of Dungeon Keeper, the godly PlayStation game. Slight pitch change. Pitch change.
not enough space. Apps and cars. Space. Nightmare. Apps and cars. Cars. Hey. A fine whip to wear. There's gonna go on.
Ben bigger.
Gonna go on.
Ben bigger.
Gonna go on.
Big bigger. And
knocking down nice old stuff.
Development. I think. Development. Things. Development. I think.
Yeah.
Wishery wasn't a commission move. I'm very grateful it wasn't, actually.
When I'd be seeing you, Mr. Potter.
Right about now, the Funk Soul Brother. Check it out now, the Funk Soul Brother.
Now.
Right about now, the Funk Soul Brother. Check it out now, the Funk Soul Brother.
Now.
Thank you.
second place, another year. Second. Second place, another year. Second.
And there we go, folks. I was scrabbling about during the last bit there to find a battery for my microphone amp. It was dead. Ah, boy. There we go, folks. Thanks very much for coming down. That was my second live mix now on live stream. I will be saving this so that you can find it on the on-demand section and you can listen to it on demand, as it would imply. I had a couple of questions back there, but because I can't scroll this chat window, I cannot read them. Oh, my sound card. Oh, my sound card's. Oh, that sounds good. Ah, oh, Focusrite. Thanks. Ah, yes, that's it. Like I said, you can grab this on demand a bit later. I guess I should stick around if you have any questions. Definitely jump into the public chat. The paburiku chatu, as they would say in Japan. And then I can answer your questions for you. Of course, if I don't, I'm just going to end up sitting here opening and closing my mouth like some kind of Muppet. So please ask me questions. Give me something to say. Pogo X sound card equals my OTP. I'll never be able to decipher that internet jargon. When will you release the Wally remix? When it's done. I love your Japanese interpretations. Thanks, I don't. I just do it because I'm bored. The Wally was indeed amazing. Oh, thanks, man. Thanks, Jisapa. Yeah, it was good fun. Oh, John doesn't like the Japanese accent. Oh, well. You can't please everybody. Yes, the Japanese accents is definitely a hobby of mine. I got onto it when I first saw a YouTube video of this guy trying to do the Matrix dialogue with a Japanese accent. And I thought it was hilarious how the Japanese can't speak English properly. So I decided I shall endeavor to imitate that. But yeah, TT Hat was awesome. Thanks, Corey Evan. I did have fun. Hope you guys did too. You and Fat Boy should collab for sure. John says he finds it racist. No, finding racist would be like Japanese are idiots or something. You know, that would be racist. Or being racist would be saying Japanese are yellow-skinned tarts or something like that. That's racism. Let's not get high and mighty on our horses. That Aladdin track was also sounded almost done. Yeah, well, I actually tried finding the Aladdin DVD in stores today, but it looks like they've taken it down. They've drawn it back into the Disney vault. I haven't found it anywhere. So unfortunately, I'm going to have to torrent it, I suppose. If you don't want people to download your movies, stop keeping them in a vault. Yes. Why are you grateful that Wishery wasn't commissioned? Well, because if it was commissioned, it probably wouldn't have come out as well. I defy you to find a client that would give you a whole year to complete a track. I defy you. Wishery took me more or less. I started work on it and then I finished it about a year later. And I think if it wasn't for giving it the passion it needed and giving it that break that it needed, it probably wouldn't have turned out the way it did if I had to rush it together in 3 weeks. Yes, you can do a pretty good... No, I can't do a very good Arnold at all. You can still say that torrenting the Wrath of Jafar. Oh, dear. Jafar would torrent, wouldn't he? Faster! That'd be good fun. Are you going to drop a new project? I drop projects all the time. I start very few, however. I probably wouldn't. I really want to get this Aladdin thing done, and I want to get the Casablanca dance track too, because everybody wants to hear it. And I suppose it does have potential. It has more potential than realized potential, so I need to get onto that and do something a little more exciting with it, because it's like, oh yes, it's another predictable pogo track. That's what I liked about what I did with the Pulp Fiction thing. I managed to get it changing more so than usual throughout the track, so that even the last section was changed up a bit. So I like that. Whereas something like Alice is the same thing from start to finish. The genie would be a Usenet junkie. Yeah, he probably would be. Besides remix, what's your favorite genre of music? Asks John. My favorite genre of music. Well, I would have to say house. I've always been a huge house fan ever since house took off in the early 90s. I suppose I was only 5 at the time, but when house evolved a bit further, I really got into house when I was like 9 or 10, and I haven't been able to get out of it since. I go in and out of drum and bass phases. I like drum and bass for a month, and then I get back out of it, and then I get back into it again. It's like once you've heard that, you've more or less heard all drum and bass tracks. I guess I'm not really... I do like drum and bass, and I love it when I get into it, but then other times I don't like it so much, so... Yes, I don't know. It's a bit of an odd one, isn't it? Did you ever consider remixing some Ghibli work? Yeah, I'm working on a Spirited Away mix, and... it's kind of coming together. It's difficult because I'm trying to do this orchestral composition stuff for Spirited Away, but I'm starting to realize that maybe that's not such a good idea, because... classical music and remixing are two very different types of music by nature, and getting them to merge, I'm finding, is quite difficult. Let me Google what house music is. Yeah, I had to Google what dubstep was, because when that whole thing came out, I was like, what the fuck is this stuff? What is this fad? House music's been around since the 90s, son. Have you ever made a remix on I was trying to learn Reason. I remember I was on tour and I had Reason on my MacBook and I was trying to figure out how to work it. And eventually I decided, oh God, forget it. Reason is not going to work out. If you watch some of my videos through the live streamed on-demand section that I've got, you can see how awesome Ableton is and how you can just drag and drop all your samples and you can cut it and you can split it and then you can route it and retime it. And it really is just super easy making remixes in Ableton Live. I think Mila of Ooh on SoundCloud only took me like a couple of hours. If you grow tired of house slash drum and bass, you might want to check out some post-dubstep. Well, I think post-dubstep is drum and bass in a way. If you've heard hardcore jungle, you'll hear all of that wub-wub stuff and you'll hear all of that grungy, you know, fluttery synthy things that seems to be what dubstep is all about. And you will hear a lot of the same formula in early 90s drum and bass. Where do you draw some inspirations from? I guess I draw inspiration from the movies I remix. Ain't that a bee? Inspiration. I did draw a lot of inspiration from Akufen. Akufen's an artist who generated a lot of interest around himself because he would make music almost entirely out of remixing sounds that he recorded off his radio tuner. And so that was, I always found that very inspiring because he would make music entirely this way. And it was intricate and it was incredible, like the intricacy he went to. Do you use both session and arrangement view of live? I try to. I would probably do it more if live was compatible with a dual monitor setup. But at the moment, no, I have to tab between them. So I prefer to use the arrangement view. Yeah, you see, if I use the clip view, I can't really get in and alter my samples, which is what you need to do. So I tend to use the arrangement view more than anything else. Have you ever used an actual drum set on a remix? Well, not an actual drum kit. I do use BFD2 a lot, which is by all extents the closest thing you'll get to a real drum kit. If I load up my Mila of Ooh track, you'll get a glimpse at BFD2 and how it works and how it actually is a set of acoustic drum kits all sampled through analog mixing desks. So it has that beautiful analog sound, which everyone seems to be forgetting these days. What have we got here? BFD2. Where are you? This is my Mila of Ooh track slowly loading. Whoops, I think I just moved something. Shit. Ooh. Okay, this is BFD2. Well, it's BFD2 going through some saturation. And for some reason, it refuses to load. It's freezing my computer. Look at that. There it is. So that's all it is, really. You got your kick drum, multi-sampled snare drum, has hats. And you can choose your different hats. You can select different Zildjians, different Bosphoruses. You can choose different snares, and so I haven't actually really recorded a drum kit myself, no, but I do use this, which is, I think, probably, I mean, you could call it a real drum kit, at least as far as your ears go, anyway. You can change your microphone mixing, like you can have just direct, you can have just the overheads. So definitely check out BFD2 if you're looking for some drums. Do you have some favorite blogs or YouTube channels? I always tune into Ashens, I always tune into AVGN, and I always tune into Nostalgia Critic. That's about the closest thing I get to to blog browsing. Are you working on any more video game remixes? No. But I have, I've been collecting all these PlayStation 1 games, and I really want to get cracking recording them, and N64 games too. Like, I want to do a kind of mega mix of, you know, like Abe's Odyssey, Banjo-Kazooie, Ocarina of Time, and just take all these awesome retro sounds straight out of the N64 and just mega mix them in the same way that I've done here. I think that'd be a lot of fun. And Parappa the Rapper, God. Parappa the Rapper had some catchy-ass tunes. I just didn't care for the stories in between them, though. Would you consider an orchestral interpretation of your remixes, or would it seem too much? Oh, you mean like Alvin Pingle? Yeah. That'd be fun, an orchestral interpretation. That's a pretty good idea, actually. I like that. That'd be fun. Have you experimented with Acid House? I don't really... No, I haven't. Oh, thanks, sound card. Thanks, that sounds great. I haven't experimented with it, no, but maybe I have stumbled upon it and I just didn't realize it. Will you be doing any collabs with Sky? Probably not, no. I don't really have a lot of time for collabs. If I'm not live streaming, I'm working on commissions and other projects. So, I mean, at the moment I'm trying to pull off a collab with Jish on an Ocarina of Time mix, which is actually working out really well. Unfortunately, I just don't have a huge amount of time to work on it. Abe's Odyssey remix would be amazing. Yes. Oh, God, yes. Yes, agreed. You have any hip-hop beats? I do. I do have some hip-hop beats. I'm working on an 80s hip-hop track at the moment, but I can't say anything more about it. Have you got a preview of your new site? I don't really know. You see, if I typed it in, I'd have to show everybody, and then that wouldn't be any good. I also like the awesome best VGM list. Hey, Nick, do you anything you want to do beyond movie game remixes? Yeah, man. I've always wanted to do filmmaking. I've wanted to make films since I was 12, I swear to God. It's just not something I can get into. I went through a couple of years of film school at SAE, and I did very well, actually. I don't have the endurance, you know? With music, it's like, I've got an idea for a song. I can belt that out in a matter of minutes, and I can finish the track while that energy is still going. But when you're making a film, I did a few short films a couple of years ago, and you know, it's like it just takes so long. It really, you have to call people, you have to audition, you have to get a crew together, you have to get equipment together, you got to go film it, you got to do multiple takes, you got to edit it, you got to sound design, you got to foley it, then you've got to grade it, and it's just like, damn, I don't know how you have that in kind of endurance. I really don't. Do you prefer instrumental or a cappella songs? I prefer instrumental, yeah. I don't like... I mean, a cappella is technically vocal only, so I guess I prefer instrumental. I don't really... I'm not a huge fan of singing and lyrics, actually. A lot of the time I hear this really great-sounding house track, and then suddenly this girl comes over and starts singing about the loss of her love life, and I'm just thinking, ah, you had a great thing going there until you came along with the cliché vocals. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of singing or lyrics. Will you go somewhere in the world for a new project? You mean like World Remix? Well, I might be going to New Zealand later this year on a trip, and if I do, I definitely want to take with my gear and maybe do some kind of world remix thing. Did you ever do anything with that short film you had on YouTube? I never did anything with it, no. My film teacher kept urging me to submit it to Tropfest in 2009 or whenever it was, but I didn't because I didn't think that much of it. If you like these old game songs, the best VGM song sure will bring you some nostalgia inspiration. Okay. Shine says, I remember that film. Oh, God, I'm sorry you do. What's the weirdest thing you've ever sampled? The weirdest thing I've ever sampled is, I would have to say, porn. And it was from a client, of all things. Adventure World has this thing called Pool Party, where they get all the adults to come down and have an adult an adult-themed pool party. And so, you know, Australian advertising being as crude and common as it is, they asked me to make a remix of Porn Sounds, and then they were going to cut footage of roller coasters going up and down and, you know, water slides going in and out to my remix. Yes, Australian advertising. Yeah, you know, girls getting it on and all that sort of thing. Huffing and puffing and all that. Yeah, that was interesting. That's definitely the weirdest thing I've ever had to sample, but it helped me pay the bills because I was renting at the time, so that was good. Bit of selling out. It's either selling out or it's supporting yourself, which is needed to continue as an artist. So, yes, it's one of those two things. Anyways, yeah, thanks for coming down, folks. Look, I'm sure you've missed the last couple of streams I've done. I've done a stream where I go through my, I go through every part of my upcoming dance track of The Secret Garden. I've gone through that in Ableton Live on live stream, so you can check that out in the on demand section. Also with Foley Moly, I've done that, and with this track, I've done that. This piece of shit right here. No, 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 no. I don't want you to solo that. So I take you through all these different samples, where they come from, how I've retimed them, how I lay the drums out, and how I master everything. Definitely check that out. I'm going to get going, folks. Thank you very much for coming down. Thanks very much for joining in on the chats and the questions. It's always good fun. Thanks for your support, folks. It's really, really awesome. I definitely wouldn't be where I am if it weren't for everyone's support. Seriously. So thanks, folks. I will be on live stream again next time. And next time, I think I'll be sure to tweet a bit more ahead in advance. I noticed that we got about 47 viewers, which is very close to my 50 cap anyway. So maybe Twittering really just isn't worth it until I can get my account verified. Apparently, the more I have saved to my account, the likelier it is I get verified. So I need to be doing more of this, I guess. Yeah. Thanks, folks. Always good fun. Thanks for the support.